Hi, I'm Anna with Marshall Communications, and Halloween is just around the corner, and so today I'm going to make a white bean turkey pumpkin chili, which sounds awesome. And I went to the store to get cannellini beans, and I could only find one can, and the recipe calls for two, but I was super excited to find these heirloom Jacob cattle beans, which, if you're from Maine, there's a really good chance Jacob's cattle beans are like your favorite. My dad used to grow these on his farm in New Gloucester, and I haven't seen them in a really long time, so finding them in the store, I was like, yes, please, I don't need two cans of cannellini. So I hope these are gonna be great. Everything else is super easy to prepare. This recipe doesn't take very long, and you can make it on the stovetop, in your slow cooker, or in an Instant Pot, depending on how much time you have and what kind of equipment you have in your home. So let's get started. I wanted to mention something about some of the ingredients that we're using today. So with carrots, if you cook them, be sure to peel them, even if the recipe doesn't say so, because if you leave the skins on and then you cook them in things like chili or stew or soup, it lends this bitterness that's really off-putting, so be sure to peel your carrots. The other thing is the correct way to chop an onion. My husband and I used to argue about this when we were first living together, about who cut onions properly. And I was right. So I'm going to show you that in just a second. After cutting your onion in half, so that the root and the top is spliced in two, you want to take your onion and then don't cut into the root. Don't cut all the way through. And you're going to make the slices depending on, you know, if you want it diced or if you want it chopped or if you want it minced. You're going to cut across the onion half. And then you have this like little attached thing. Then, when you're chopping, everything's connected, and so it just makes it easier to have more control and get a more consistent size. So, this is the right way to chop an onion. The first step, once you have all your veggies prepped, is heating some olive oil in a, if you're doing the stovetop version, in a nice big pot. And we're doing carrots and onions and celery, which I will stir with my huge kitchen spoon because I was on the winning team. So we're going to let these soften up, and then we add the garlic and the spices, and then the turkey. And then we're halfway through the recipe. So once the turkey's browned, then you add 2 cups of broth, the can of pumpkin, the fresh herbs and some salt, and then the rinsed and drained beans. And I'm just gonna sort of mix these together a little bit, and then I'll put the lid on, partially covering it for 25 minutes, and bring it up to a simmer. And then you add the cream and you're done. Super easy. So the last step, when everything's simmered, is to add some heavy whipping cream. You can probably get away with half and half, but because I always forget to buy whipping cream, I buy these little boxes from Trader Joe's and they last a really long time on your shelf. So it's great to have these around in instances like this where I didn't remember to buy the whipping cream. So I'm just gonna blend that in and then you are done. You can add some extra salt if you want or some more pepper, but this looks fantastic.